I just seen my whole life just fall apart, saying to myself that there is no God and deciding I'm gonna live my life for myself. I was never been in such a darker place in my life. I was okay with like being arrested, going to jail and dying by the time I'm 30. I pleaded to God, either take me or save me. I said, I can't go on like this, though. I can't live like this anymore. I finally found Harvest and Niles, and I really dedicated my life to Christ at that moment when I went forward. I came to Christ with nothing, I mean, bankrupt. You know, and Christ has just provided me with so much.
I met my lovely wife, Jen. God really placed Africa on my heart and mission, so I prayed about it and started looking up Liberia, and we found there was a hospital there that actually had dire needs for someone with medical like Jen and also for finance and accounting.
There's about one doctor for every 100,000 people. I just think about the medical needs there. Sometimes I just can't help but think, how can I not go?
We're missionaries in Liberia for 2 years, and we just returned back to the United States in August of 2018.
Working at the hospital every day in the emergency room obviously was extremely challenging, working in an under-resourced area where we didn't always have what we needed. Many times I'd have several deaths in one day that I had to witness. It was very difficult, you know, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, physically, working in those conditions.
Seeing people we got to love and know dearly, and seeing their kids die, seeing their kids not having food, it really shook us to the core. God just, on so many different occasions there, took us apart and put us back together. And it was a process we walked through with God, and we needed to be faithful to the calling He's given us. We carried with us a burden for unreached people, people that are living in, you know, 99% Muslim areas that will never walk past a single church. They'll never meet a single Christian in their lives. And I woke up one day, it was just on my heart and my mind, was this idea of Africans reaching Africa. Why can't we mobilize the believers here? Why can't we send them out? And I talked to Jen about it. At first we thought we were crazy. We kept saying, you know what, we're gonna put one foot in front of another, and Lord, unless you close this door, we're gonna keep pursuing it.
Our mission is to mobilize African believers to go to unreached people groups in West and North Africa to evangelize, disciple, and plant churches in fulfillment of the Great Commission.
I'm at one meeting with 70 pastors and I shared this vision. All of them came up to me and said, we've never sent missionaries out. Missions has always been something that Western people, that you people do, but it's never been something we do. Bill, this is such a great thing for Liberia. This is such a great thing for the local church. When I told them, God might require your life. Where you're going is very dangerous. Places that are 99% Muslim, places that have persecution. Without blinking an eye, they would say, you know, Bill, us Liberians, we don't normally like to brag, but there's one thing we're really good at is suffering. If our blood has to be the seed for the gospel to go forward in these places, we're willing to go. March of 2018, we sent out our first group of 10 missionaries, church planters, out into three countries. We have some Bible studies going on in some of these places, and we're praying that out of that, we're gonna see a local church planted. Our goal is for people to come to know Jesus, for people in these places where it's been generation after generation of Islamic stronghold, to be able to break those chains and see the freedom that is in Jesus Christ that we've all come to know, that we've come to love and know Him.
You know, it's a very slow process a lot of times with Muslims, but God has been opening the door, and they've seen several that have come to Christ.
A couple of their family members, who, when they found out they became believers, reported our missionaries to the police. They were charged as being spies and rebels in this country, even though they've done nothing wrong but preach the gospel. And now some of those very policemen is asking them to do a Bible study. God is moving in missions that we haven't seen in a long time. Matthew 24:14 says that before the end will come, this gospel must be proclaimed and reached out to all nations. And seeing a multitude of people from every nation, tribe, and tongue reached with this gospel, that's what we're working towards.
The world behind me, the cross before me, the world behind me.
We plan on going back to Africa in January. God provides, we have plans to send out another 6 to 8 families that are believers that will go to these difficult to reach areas.
We're thankful for the prayers from everyone. We're thankful for the gifts and for the partnership and the love that we felt and received from Harvest through all of this. We would not have been able to do this without you guys. one of the pastors in Liberia and said, you know what, this is something God would do. He takes an accountant and a nurse to start a church movement in Africa to send out the first missionaries from this country. And so we just find ourselves here with open hands, you know, saying, Lord, this is your ministry, this is your thing.